look? How did he look to you after today?
I thought he looked good.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, his first day back, so he, you know, tried not to push it too much, but, you know, he pretty much did everything. Just really careful with him.
No discomfort that you could tell or that he's mentioned to you?
Well, just careful. Yeah. You know what I mean? Just trying to be careful his first day back, so I didn't want to push him too much. He did what he could do, and pretty much he did most of the practice.
Well, I was going to ask you a little bit about Jimmy Britton. I mean, he's a guy you moved around a little bit. He got moved from the safety, and then I think he was an outside linebacker first, then inside. Last year you were hoping he might be able to step up. He wasn't able to get the starting job. You had to move Sargenti in. But it looks like he's finally found his groove, so to speak. He's been playing pretty well.
Yeah, no, he went from safety to inside. But he's who we are. I mean, very unselfish, tough, smart, hard-nosed. He comes to, you know, practice every day and on a mission. I mean, he's exactly a Navy football player. When I think of a Navy football player, I think of Jimmy. Just, you know, he's banged up, just tapes his elbow and keeps going, tapes his shoulder and keeps going. I mean, he's a tough, hard-nosed kid.
And is it nice to see a kid who, you know, has been trying to get in the lineup, he's been playing special teams, and finally he's emerging.
And it doesn't surprise you. I mean, you know, we always tell these kids, the guy that gets on the field is the kid who perseveres. There's a lot of hard things here. A lot of times things look bleak, but if you just keep persevering, keep grinding, keep working, eventually the sun comes up, eventually things start to work out. And like you said, I'm happy for a guy like Jimmy that that's happening.
And this, you have a history of this with linebackers in particular, of seniors who emerge, you know, Keegan Wetzel and Ram and others. We can name seven guys that are, as seniors, stepped up and played and did well.
Yeah, and it's a position, there's a toughness part of that, obviously, at that position at linebacker. And I think the grind of working your way up and getting to that, you know, it kind of calluses you.
Mm-hmm.
It prepares you for that position. I mean, it's a tough position. You know, they spread you out and throw the ball all over the place. They run the ball at you. And so you got to be a tough kid to do that. And so I think all of that builds into that part of building a linebacker.
What, I was at 92, Gorduke, he's got a huge, the Bobby McLaren club. What's his situation?
I think he'll be back soon. I mean, his finger's still setting, but I think he'll be okay.
Right, but will not play this week?
No, he won't play this week.
Right, did it happen last week?
No, it happened a couple weeks ago.
Okay. It looked like your unit took some licks on Saturday night. I'm going to guess that what they were doing defensively puts the slots kind of at risk when you're firing the corners. They're open and exposed to some hits, right?
Yeah, but it's like that every week. I mean, it's our fault. We got to block them. We just didn't do a good job on the perimeter. You know, other people have done that. That's not the answer, you know, obviously, to anything that we do. But if we'd have blocked them better, that game would have been a lot different earlier. But, you know, we'll play who shows up. We got some guys beat up, you know. Next guy's gotta come up and play. They all practice. They just all got. I mean, the expectation level is the same. I don't care who it is. You know, younger guys, whoever hasn't played much. We got some guys that played a little bit, but not as much as some of the older guys. They gotta play well. They're gonna be expected to play well. They gotta prepare well this week. And you know, I expect them to play well. So we don't make any excuses for the young guys.
DeBrandon and DeMond, does it look like they probably won't be able to go on Saturday?
I don't have any idea. I know they didn't practice today. We'll wait. We'll find out from Doc. I'll talk to them, kind of see how they feel.
I even told you.
But
after the phone interview.
I don't know. We just kind of, whoever's there, we'll play.
Football lobby.
Try to find, you know, two healthy bodies at a time.
Yeah, I didn't see you.
Turn it loose, see how it happens.
Based on the fact that they both went out of the game on Saturday night, I guess it was opportune time for Dyson to come back.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I mean, he was back. I mean, he was playing. He just, you know, that was his first game, first time ever playing in a game.
Right.
So, he'll play a lot better. He's a heck of a player. I expect a lot of him. You know, that was his first time playing, but I still expect him to play well. And I'll expect him to play well Saturday, and he will. He's still not, you know, 100%, but every day he gets a little bit better. So, hopefully he'll be 100%. There's no better time than Saturday to be 100%. So.
If DeMond and DeBrandon don't go on Saturday, does it just shorten the rotation, or do you add another guy?
I mean, it all depends on how, you know, all those guys play special teams. You know, if guys get tired, we'll roll somebody else in. But Calvin's role will be expanded.
Calvin Cass.
You know, Dyson, he's got to play. He's got to play well. Antonio's role's got to increase, you know, and he's played a little bit this year, but not meaningful reps, you know, not a lot of, you know, you know, big time reps. So, you know, I just talked to those guys after practice. They got to step up. I mean, you know, whoever's at the stadium on Saturday, whoever's playing, whoever's healthy is going to play, and the expectation level for the position doesn't change. You know, if they got to block, they got to block. If they got to catch the pitch, they got to catch the pitch. They need to know where to go. They need to know what to do. If the ball's thrown to them, they need to catch it. So, you know, we don't make any excuses, you know. We saw that last week when the backup quarterback came in. We expect to play well. We played well. So, you know, backup A-back comes in, 13 A-back comes in, he's got to play well. There's no other alternative. If we don't, and whoever's in don't play well, we won't move the ball. We won't play well. So pressure's on us. We just got to do it.
All right. Thanks, Dan.
Thank you.
Like, you know, obviously, I think you've been playing pretty well here at the beginning of this year. And just talk about what you've been through. You started off as a safety. You get moved positions. I know last year they were looking for you to kind of take over at inside linebacker. It didn't work out, and they had to move Sargenti in there. Just kind of tell me the progression you've been through. And, I mean, I guess it's just it's a work in progress, and you're starting to see some rewards.
I guess I got to learn all the defense from a different position. So
right.
I know everybody else is seeing.
That's a good point.
So, no, it's I'm just happy to be where I'm at now, and just keep moving forward. So.
What is improve? Any areas you feel you've improved upon from last year? That, you know, obviously last year you didn't earn the starting job. This year you're now in, you know, in essence it's a three-man starting rotation in there with you, Jordan, and Daniel. But what have you gotten better at? What have you improved upon?
I think you know, strike shed, use my hands, and you know, blocks more. So.
Right. What is the pass coverage different inside? I mean, I know that's part of what they liked about your, you know, background as in the defensive backfield. You had the pick this past week, but is it a different deal playing pass coverage at inside linebacker?
Just different coverage responsibility. So it's not it's not as like backwards or forwards, more lateral.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they just moved me there because I was bad at covering safety. So.
Oh, come on now. What is it? And is the physical side of it been something you've had to get accustomed to? You're up there taking poundings from, you know, I guess guards get on you at times, or, you know, you're getting offensive linemen on you every now and again. You got to try to shed. Is it just a lot more physical up there in the front seven?
It is. It's a lot more fun up there. So, I liked the switch 2 years ago, so I'm happy.
So do you feel like this year, I mean, the fact that you've been playing so well here in the first few games, do you think it's just a case of getting more comfortable, that kind of deal?
Yeah, definitely. I think so. So, I mean, just reps and experience.
Right. All right, Jimmy. Thanks, man.
Thank you.
Okay.